This is nerve-wracking. This is my very first time doing anything like this, and I know it's a bit of a cliche, but it is like losing your virginity. It's very scary, it's very terrifying. There are a few differences, obviously. I do actually want to be laughed at tonight. And lasting 5 minutes is a job well done. So I went to the optician's the other day to get my eyes tested. They observed the moisture, you will notice I'm wearing glasses. And it's a very strange occupation, the optician's, because it's the only job that I can think of, really, where you do the job for them. So I don't know if you've ever been to the optician's, but you all know about, you know, the little thing in the back with the letters. And you sit in the chair, and he sits down, and he puts these big glasses on you that are like something like Ghostbusters or something. And he'll put the lens in. And he'll say, right, Mark, what I want you to do is look at the screen behind you, and I want you to tell me which one's clearer. Number one, or number two? And I don't know, my optician, he doesn't just say number one or number two, number one or number two. This is the only real excitement in his life, so he makes a performance and a song and dance out of it. So, you know, he's, okay, you ready, Mark? Yeah, I'm ready, yeah, yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, number one, or number two? And that's a lot of pressure on me, really, because, this is my eyesight we're talking about. It's quite a big deal, quite important, really. And you're asking me? I don't fucking know. I can't see. My eyes have been fucked since I was 7, so I don't trust him anyway. So he's standing there and he's asking, you know, number one, number two. And you kind of go, oh, I don't know. Can I see number one again? Can I see number two again? Is there number three? What if they're both blurry? I don't know. I can't take this pressure. I can't choose. I can't commit. I don't know. I'm going to have to commit. Okay, one. Yeah, one. Yeah, one actually. Yeah, it's definitely one. It's one. It's one. I know it's one. So that's going to go through all the way, through the whole thing. You're just like second guessing yourself. Okay, you go, one or two. And you get to the end. And it's quite an exciting time actually. You've made your way through ones and twos. And you know, a couple of days later, you go pick up your new glasses. It's quite exciting. Yeah, new glasses. Fantastic. Looking around you. And the first thought that comes into your head, fucking knew it was number two. So it's a stressful time. I like that rather the optician just kind of took that pressure away from her. My wife dragged me to a musical the other day. I fucking hate musicals. I really can't stand them. Does anybody like musicals here? Yeah, we're going to get on great. I hate them. And the reason I hate them is because all of a sudden they'll just burst into song! Quite rapidly, like that. And it kind of takes me out of it, because that type of stuff doesn't happen in real life, you know? I want to go to a film, I'm immersed, I'm with the character, I'm there, I'm in the story. And then they just fall right out of the fucking blue. And I've never been in a situation where I've thought, I'm in the middle of a conversation and gone, do you know what? I might say this. Might sing this. I think the message I want to get across would be better delivered in song. There's not enough melody in this conversation for my life. You know, so I don't mind. And the thing is, can you imagine if this did happen in real life? You know, like if you went to your doctor and your doctor was a big fan of musicals? But yeah, it wouldn't be good, would it really? Well, Mr. Woodrow, it's very bad news, I'm afraid. You're going to lose a bollock! You're only half a man. If our big family's on the cards, it's time for a change of plan. It's quite devastating news, actually, Doctor. Don't think you ever sing that to me.